Hi everyone and welcome back to the Leeds United Career Mode. Welcome to the finale of the series. This FIFA 22 Leeds United Career Mode has been very inconsistent in terms of, you know, how often I've uploaded and things like that. And I really do apologise for that. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed the series. And in this episode, to give you some very, very simple, blunt context, we have four games remaining. And there will only be four games remaining regardless. We have the FA Cup final against West Ham. We have a home game against Spurs, and then a few days later, a home game against Aston Villa, where, I mean, we could win the league in this one against Spurs, and if we don't win that, we can still win it against Aston Villa. I'm going to show you the Premier League table because you can kind of get a better idea of where we stand. So, obviously, 99 goals scored, second best defence in the league, obviously the best attack, but we're in prime position. We have a game in hand on City. So they can get a max of 86 points. So if we even get a point against Spurs, we will have won the league. But if we win against Tottenham, we will have 100% wrapped it up. So, you know, that's all well and good. But obviously, like I said, we're in the FA Cup final. I obviously want to win this one against West Ham. And then the big one, the Champions League final against Bayern München. I want the treble, so let's go get the treble. Obviously, I'm going to put our full-strength starting 11 up against West Ham, but in saying that, I am sort of debating a bit just because that game against Tottenham, I mean, we could win the league. Well, we will win the league if we get the win in that game. So I am thinking of resting, like, a player or two. And I think just because he's a little bit unfit, I might bring him on or something. I'm going to give Pavon the start in the FA Cup final. Potentially a bit of a risk, but we know how good Christian Pavon is. I think he's actually quick. Oh, he's not quicker than Bailey. Bailey's a better player. But I'm saying Pavon is still a great, great winger. So I think he'll be a very, very reliable player to put in for this game. Apart from that, it's just our first team, eh? West Ham have an old familiar face of, for me, Lise Mousset, the old Bournemouth striker, along with, I think that's Nampalis Mendy. I don't know which Sanchez that is. It could be Alexis Sanchez, but it's probably not. That's a pretty weak team, to be honest. I think we should batter them. We are the current holders of the FA Cup trophy. So today is definitely a game that we, you know, want to win. This is a game we want to win, I mean. Like I said, we should be turning these over because they're just not as good as us. Quite simple, they're just not as good as us. We could be in early here. Pavon, who we of course brought in for this game, plays Valverde and Valverde loses it. Here's Walker. He's got the pace to drive into the box. Whoa, my god, Mason saved it onto the post. I didn't really see an option to pass, so I just thought I'd whack it. Walker's taking out his man. Oh, no. No, ref, you've had a howler there, mate. There's no chance that's a red. It's a bad tackle. It's a yellow card. I'll take that. Not a red. Not a red. He hasn't got the ball or anything, but it's not a red. Unfortunately, we've been wrongfully shot down to 10 men. Shot. Anyway, why don't we just go get the win? That'll make it a lot better. Is the pass going to find Rashford? No, I mean, I didn't even want it to find Rashford. I was going for Olmo, but Rashford decided he wanted it, so he went for it in the end. Lads, soak it up. You're on the back foot now. You lot are down to 10 men, so you're on the back foot. We've got it here with Ward-Prowse. Rashford is making a disgracefully bad run. So we're going to have to pick out Pavon. Pavon's run into the box. He pulls it across and Rashford's hanging out at freaking left back. And I'm sorry for the glitch. Nothing I can do. You guys know. What are you doing, lads? Oh, it's because we had Walker sent off and I haven't fixed up a formation or anything. Oh, no. 1-0. Thank you, Yarmolenko. Unfortunately, Danny Olmo might have to be the sacrificial lamb. Going to bring Henricks on. Here's Rashford. There's a gap. Just hit that. Oh, what a tackle from the defender. No. Here's Lanzini now. One of you has to get there. And the refs pointed to the spot. Do not send another man off. I'm so done. What is this ref doing? We're 1-0 down. Like, okay, it's a penalty. But both of those red cards are just not red cards. I don't know. Rashford's going to have to come back to left back, I guess. Ward-Prowse. Okay. Come on, we need more of that. Valverde. Oh. Win it, Valley. We haven't won it, and we haven't won the seconds because they outnumber us. There's the shot coming in just wide of the post. The ref is definitely a West Ham fan. Ward-Prowse carry. I see that run of Valverde. Valo, please. Yes. The nine men of Leeds. Okay. Ward-Prowse and Valverde link up sensationally, and then a lace finish into the side netting. That's what we needed. That's absolutely what we needed. And I just realized that my room light's on. There we go. I think that's a little bit better. Probably doesn't make much of a difference. Probably looked better before, you know. But anyway, 1-1. That's huge. Thank you, Valo. With that Tottenham game just around the corner in a matter of literally days, we can't afford to go to extra time. We need to just win it in normal time. Everybody has to get back now. Pavon, you got a job to do, mate. Yarmolenko. There we go, Pavon. Solid as a rock. Uh-oh. Someone get there. What have we given? They've given a yellow card for them. I have no idea what for, and I just do not care. Thank God that we've got that decision our way. Just chuck it through the center. Oh, my God. Oh, Marlon almost got on the end of that. It was a wishful through ball. But again, I kind of need to conserve my possession a bit better here because we can't... Oh, Ward-Prowse, don't do that. Every time we win the ball back fair and square, that freaking happens. Or we get sent off. I'm only joking, obviously. Okay. Come on. Have to score, lads. No option. Oh, Ward-Prowse, get off the pitch, bro. Shocking. Shocking, shocking, shocking. He goes straight off. I'd say Rodrigo. We really should be losing this game. I mean, obviously at the start I was like, oh yeah, we should batter him. We should batter them. I mean, oh, hang on. There we go. The fact that we're down to nine men and not losing 5 or 6 nil just shows how... Oh, what a tackle, Valverde. Just shows how bad they are, really. Hang on. Play Rashford. Oh, my God. Please, Marcus. You've missed so many of these all season. Near post. How have you missed again? No. Oh, that's such a poor finish. Bloody hell, mate. Laporte's in there. He's never going to win that. And Henricks has somehow lost that duel there. No one's gone to win it. And I was sitting here saying that we can't go to extra time and whatever, and we're going to extra time. Cannot believe Rashford missed that chance. That's crazy. Pavon loses it. There's the overlap from Henricks. Come on. Valverde is in there again. Pavon. Oh, my God. He missed. Oh, my God. God. What is happening? Valverde misses again. I mean, I don't think Valverde's actually missed today. He scored our goal. Anyway, we miss again. Valverde stays ahead of his man. Rodrigo. Rashford saved by Mason. That was a much more difficult chance for Rashford. I just want to score. I just want it to be over. Laporte's there. Yes! As I was saying, I just want to score. Aymeric Laporte, who has come up trumps for us so much this season, from up in their box to obviously in our box, where he's made so many decisive defensive plays. And Mason's had a quality game, to be fair, but after Laporte got his nutter on that, there's nothing he's doing to stop it. So I will make my last change after that one. We are going to hold on for dear life. Jesus, look at our team. This is ridiculous. Five at the back. I've not really changed my formation in-game this series, probably for the whole thing. Maybe four in the midfield. No, I'd rather a narrow formation. So, nah. So we're gonna do this. This is crazy. Absolutely everyone back. Henrichs can go right centre back. Pavon can go out there. Marlon can come off. Ayling can come on. That's how we're lining up. Aymeric Laporte may have just saved us in the FA Cup final with 5 minutes of regular time to go. I mean, you can't write it. They don't get the ball, then they can't score. The 9 men of Leeds have absolutely done a job. Romero sat that man on his ass. Rashford. Go on, Vallo. Oh, we scored again. West Ham were expecting us to just keep it rooted at our back line, but we've played it forward. Valverde has a brace. Rodrigo, Rashford, great link-up play. Number two for West Ham, I think that's for Sharko. Ain't picking up Vallo, and he whacks it into the corner. 3-1, we've won the FA Cup. We have won it. Wow. Being 1-0 down, being down to 9 men, not just 10, 9 men. And for my mindset to be played with so much due to those red cards just not being red cards. Oh, to come and win that is crazy. Very happy Laporte got that goal. Valverde, though, absolutely astounding with his 2 goals and overall display. Melier, just like he did last year, is going to lift the FA Cup trophy. And I'm very happy about it. I'm very happy. Go on, Ilan. Lift that bloody trophy, you little legend. 3-1 against West Ham. Job's not done. That's 1 out of 3. That's 1 out of 3. 1 out of 3 trophies, at least. But it's only 1 out of 4 games. Of course, we have this one against Spurs. And if we win it, it's very simple. We will be crowned Premier League champions for 2023-24. Spurs are currently outside the top four. They have a game in hand on Leicester. So if they win, then they keep their top four hopes alive. So it's kind of big for them. Well, it's actually huge for them. You know what I'm saying? So we desperately need this. We desperately, desperately need this. Bit of a headache for team selection. Oh, they've done this glitch, have they? Well, that's just perfect. Thanks to that glitch that still never got fixed on FIFA 22, that you can't take players out of your lineup if they got red carded. Just going to have to wait and see what happens then. All right then, Spurs, bring it on, lads. Bring it on. You can't contend with us, I'm telling you. We're going to win today. I've got a great feeling about this game. We beat Tottenham at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium earlier in the season in a thrilling game. I don't even remember the score. I just remember the fact that it was a good game. Marlon has some space and time, and it's over the bar. Bailey turns his man. Electric. Taken out. Penalty. Thank you very much, Leon Bailey. And a very controversial sending off for Ben Davies. They're down to 10 minutes. Red card central this episode. 3 in 1.1 games. I don't know. I'll say 1 in a game in a bit. But Davies is sent off. Penalty time. James Ward-Prowse. I suck at penalties. Oh, thank you. I thought that it was saved by the keeper, but Ward-Prowse in the end did enough. It was a great penalty into the side netting. I just realized they brought Henrichs in at right back, but I think that's Rodrigo at left back. Who programs a system to think, oh yeah, I'll bring in my central attacking mid slash striker in after my left back has been suspended? Thankfully, we've won a cheap free kick there. That's crazy. That's so funny. Oh well, let's see how he does. Let's see how he gets on. Go on, Henrichs. Oh, Henrichs is turning his man. Straight out to Valverde, who can hit this on his left. Oh, what a goal from Federico Valverde. The 10 men of Tottenham are crumbling. Valverde, who rescued us in that FA Cup final, has come in. Oh, well, Laporte did, but Valverde got the first and last goal. He got the goal to seal it. Wow. How about that from Henrichs? Twisting and turning. He finds Valverde, who's picked up a pocket of space, and he's picked out the corner with his weak foot. He's such a cheat code, Federico Valverde. 2-0 leads. Come on, boys. I still can't believe Rodrigo's playing left back. Come on, mate. Show him how to do it. Oh, take that, Castagna. Big Rodrigo, the left back. He's galloping forward. Junior Firpo, who he says. Go on. Rodrigo, oh, that's shocking. Jesus, he's almost gone out for a freaking throw-in, mate. That's so bad. I am going to get rid of his position. Like, okay, it's funny playing left back, but the joke's over half an hour in. I'm actually going to bring Dallas on. So we've still not got a natural left back there, but Stuart Dallas is much better acquainted to play left back than Rodrigo. We're just being patient with it now, lads. Ward-Prowse with the finesse, saved by Wame. Look at the tiki-taka. Don't know why he played it to Dallas when I told him to play it to Marlon. Oh, that's why, because now we found Marlon, who finds the back of the net. We're a few seconds out from halftime, and we've made it 3-0. We've made it 3-0. We're having fun against Tottenham. Tottenham, one of the top sides in the league, and we're toying with them. Yes, they're down to 10 men, but we just won the FA Cup final with 9. You get me? This is an historic day for Leeds United Football Club. Look at that link-up play. That just sums up our season. We've been offensively rude. That's our 102nd goal of the season, by the way. Ridiculous. And Marlon's 29th. Ridiculous. Like I said, I think Marlon's pretty well... I think him and Salah were neck and neck for Golden Boot last time I checked. Oh, lads. What a save by the keeper. The captain, Ilan Meslier, has just said no to Tottenham as they search for a way back into this game. That is one of the best saves I've ever seen. And that is Premier League captain, Premier League winning captain material, I should say. We're killing them, lads. We're absolutely slapping them a new one. Look at that. The one-touch football. It's beautiful. Valverde finds Marcus Rashford, who can just run and hit it with his left. 4-0, you know. 4-0. Ridiculous, boys. Unbelievable. We are crushing Spurs. The Premier League title is ours. I'm going to bring Marlon off. Give Bamford a run out. I forgot we even had Gellar. That's a bit sad, isn't it? He did pretty well in our first season, and then we just got Marlon and forgot about him. My bad. We'll bring in Koch, give Laporte a rest, and I think that'll do. Dallas just puts him on his ass. Lets him know that he can't mess with us. Rashford over to Leon Bailey here. Bailey with the left-footed effort. It's a great save. Still 4-0 though. I mean, that's embarrassing for Spurs. Even down to 10. Even against the league. Not just the league leaders, the freaking league winners, bro. The league winners, I'm so happy. Anyway, even against the league winners, that's embarrassing. Okay, that should be it. Any time now, ref. There it is. Come on, Leeds. We've done the domestic double. Obviously, the UCL trophy is there for the taking. And it's there. It's what we're going to take next, of course. But that is massive. 4-0 victory. We've won the Prem at Elland Road. How beautiful is that? How freaking awesome is that? So deserved. What a team we've built here at Leeds. Just constantly doing smart business, constantly winning big games. I mean, this season we've just killed everyone, you know. Apart from that 1-0 loss to City, we had like... Well, we had obviously that period where we lost 2-1 to Liverpool and then 2-1 to Everton at home. That was pretty much the only hiccup. Apart from that, we were so consistent throughout the campaign. And yes, job's not finished, but Ilan Meslier... His arms are getting tired, not just from saving all them shots in between the sticks, but from lifting trophies, and it's the first time that Leeds lift the Premier League title. They won a few top-flight titles back in the day, but this is the first time they've won the Premier League. And how good is that? How freaking good is that? Meslier lifts it. He's been so good for us, man. So have the whole team. The fans thoroughly deserve it. Great support throughout the season. We have one more Prem game to go, but doesn't really matter. That's quite irrelevant because, as you can see, we've won the big one. So I'll put the B team out for that, I reckon. Come on, boys. Look at that. How good. How good. So just for confirmation there, as you can see, one game to go. We're 5 points ahead of City. Marlon's looking pretty well sealed for the Golden Boot with 29. That is stunning. Last game of the Premier League season against Aston Villa. I don't really need to rest the lads because we have that game against Bayern in a few days' time. I am going to use the first team just because I can. Hopefully we don't get any injuries because that would really annoy me. And it's a 2-0 win. No injuries or nothing. Marlon got another goal. That's 30 for the season. And then Valverde wrapped it up in added time. I mean, yeah, what a team we have. What a team we have. Now it's just time for the Champions League final, I guess. There's nothing else to say. There's nothing I need to say to justify how huge this is. How much money did we get from the Prem? 180 mil. Not bad. Not bad at all. It's a shame we won't get to spend that. So that's going to go in our kitty for next season. But again, we're not going to get to use it. Because we've won the Premier League, we've won the major trophy that we set out to win. But also, we could do the treble. So let's just put everything aside for this buying game and hopefully go out with a bang. I would hate to do all this hard work, win the Prem, win the FA Cup, and then not win the Holy Grail, that is the Champions League. But let's not think about losing. Let's think about freaking winning. Come on, lads. So back in February is where our knockout journey in the Champions League began. A 5-2 win away at Napoli was the difference maker in the round of 16. Obviously, put the B team out for the 3-1 loss at home, but no one really cares about that. We got through 6-5. And against Liverpool, it was the away leg that proved decisive with a 3-2 win on aggregate. After a 2-2 draw at home, we won away 1-0. Same with PSG, but after a 2-2 draw at home, we went to their place and smashed them 4-0. So, mate, if that's not a testament to us just having to be in the Champions League final, then I don't know what is. Let's not beat around the bush anymore. Let's get into it. Obviously, it's going to be the first team, the fully fit first team, mind you. They've got Koke at left back, and then Tellez at centre back, and then Denier at right back, and then Kimmich at centre mid. Weird one. It's at the San Siro as well. How lovely. 3 years is all it's taken us to not only win the Prem, not only win the FA Cup, but get into a Champions League final and be in a position for a treble. I mean, that's incredible. We've done such good business over the seasons and all that sort of stuff. We've built such an amazing team. Ilan Meslier will lead his team out for one final time in this series. I'm so excited. Let's get straight into it, lads. Let's beat Bayern. Let's prove that we are the true kings of European football, that we are a juggernaut that no one can truly contend with. Come on. Rashford with the strike just wide of the post. Laporte with a great ball into the feet of Ward-Prowse. I did not try and go to Bailey. I told him to pass it to Valverde, but in typical FIFA fashion, it goes to the wrong player, who just so happens to be offside as well. We've gone into the feet of Valverde. Bailey's kept his run and he's stayed onside. We should really be attacking this side of Bayern's defence, and that's why we almost got in behind for a goal there. We did the getting in behind part, but Neuer was equal to Bailey's shot. Good save in the end, but the Bayern captain, Koke, playing left back. It's a weird one. It's a real weird one. Come on. Laporte's in there. He's done it again, you know. Aymeric Laporte, just before the half-hour mark, has made it 1-0 in the Champions League final. This man is insane. He did it in the FA Cup final, and he's done it here. Ward-Prowse with a great corner. And Laporte, free as a bird, you know. He evaded the marking of Upamecano and then out jumps Tellez and all that. And Neuer didn't stand a chance. 1-0, come on. Leon Bailey. I see that run of Kyle Walker. Marlon. Well read in the end. Oh, what a save by Neuer. Valo could have made it too. It was great work from the lads. Valo's free as a bird. Yeah, it's not a bad finish. It's just a good save, I think. Let's get this corner in. Maybe look for Laporte again. He's there. He almost won it, to be fair. He's going to look to play it back. So just hold him there on the wing. Beautiful stuff. Risky from Romero, but it's so good in the end. Walker can play it in front of Vallow here. He's got space. Into the feet of Ward-Prowse. This great link up from the lads. It's great awareness. It's great team play. Olmo can hit this. Ooh, almost 2-0. I think that might put the game to bed if we go 2-0 up before the break. The header is there. Walker hits it on the volley. Upamecano with the diving header block. There's half time. 1-0. We've definitely been the better team. Bayern have just not got going. We could be more than one up. We could be 2 or 3, maybe even 4-0 up. But I'll take the 1-0 lead. Let's build on it in the second half. Rashford's got time here. He picks out a pass. Olmo. Terrible first touch from Danny Olmo. The Spanish wizard. There was no magic in that, mate. That was a freaking mundane potion from Minecraft. This isn't good. We're only 10 minutes into the second half. Bayern looking like they want it a lot more than they did in the first half. Laporte's there with a great header. Look at that from Rashi boy. Great tackle again from Laporte. So solid. Man of the match so far. He got our goal and he got that tackle for us. Firpo has given away one of the stupidest fouls I have ever seen. I don't even need to tell you why I hate that so much. Romero wins the header. Marlon can carry. Outpace him, Marlon. Outpace him. Still got it. He's done well. Rashford into the feet of Marlon. Just smash it, Marlon. Great save by Neuer in the end. Oh my God, it's one ball. One ball and they're in. Coman's going to try and look to cut it back. And we got him. We got him. Olmo, take it in your stride. Go on, son. Oh, Marlon's way offside. God damn it, he played the pass too late. We've only got 10 plus minutes left, just about. So I'm going to make some changes. I'm going to bring Walker's been good. I'm going to bring Firpo off. I don't want to go down to 10 minutes at any point. I'm going to bring, I think, Bailey off for Christian Pavon. So Pavon's a really good player. He's actually battled really well for that starting winger spot, but Bailey just sometimes produces those moments of quality and it's like, bro, it's not rivaled by anyone like Pavon or even Rashford at times, but he's not very as consistent as someone like Rashford. I can definitely say that. Bayern are hungry. I can tell they want that goal and they're now in behind with Coman. He's been causing us problems this game, especially in the second half, but Henrik's locking up. Here's Ward-Prowse. Let's hit them on the counter. Come on. Ward-Prowse over to Walker. He's got the pace on this man. Can he? He forgot the ball when he ran over Thomas Muller's legs, who's in a centre-back position at the moment. Fair enough. You do you, Bayern Munich. You do you. Oh my God, almost through the middle. We're in stoppage time. It's Danny Olmo. No options anywhere. Tellers with the tackle. But that's it. That's it. We've won it. Oh my God, we've won it. Champions League victory for Leeds United. Treble, baby. There's the Prem. There's the FA Cup. And here is the Champions League as well. Just for the cherry on top. Aymeric Laporte, the man that scored that crucial goal in the FA Cup final. He's been probably the best signing we've made in the series. He's the one to score the header and win the game for us in the Champions League final. Unbelievable stuff. The boys have done it. Bayern really never looked like troubling us. They went in down our wing a couple times and we just said, nah, bro, you're not coming and scoring. You're not taking this off us. We could have had a few more ourselves, especially in that first half. But at the end of the day, 1-0 win. Drama free, really. And just a nice little treble for Leeds United. I think you can safely say that that's a job well done. Fifth place in our first season. Second place in an FA Cup victory in our second season. Premier League, FA Cup, and the Champions League in season 3. With Leeds United, Melier's arms are about to fall off now after carrying all these trophies around the gaff. What a beautiful sight. The Holy Grail, the Champions League. is now in possession of Leeds United. Look at the Bayern fans. So funny. Melier gives it all he's got, you know, here at the San Siro. What a beautiful sight. All that hard work led to this very moment. So proud of the lads. So proud. All right, let's end the season with some player stats across the club. I think it's definitely worth looking at this. Obviously, Melier racked up the most appearances. I mean, what a man. For a goalkeeper in FIFA 22 to average a 7.0 match rating is incredible. And if you take out that 6 match rating from the Community Shield, he's probably averaging about, give or take, a 7.1 or 2 there. So, what a man, Ilon Melier. Just a legend. Just an absolute freaking legend. Nothing more to say. El Capitano, 24 years of age, and he's won it all. So, what a beautiful man. Top goal scorer was, of course, Donyell Marlon in the Prem. He got a goal involvement every game on average. He got 30 goals in 36 games along with 6 assists. He bagged 1 in the Community Shield, 5 in 11 in the Champions League. He got 1 in the FA Cup. Such a beast. Marcus Rashford with a 20-20 season. He got a lot of assists. I didn't actually realise. He got 18-12 in the Prem, 3-5 in the FA Cup, 5-3 in the Champions League. Averaged 7.6 as a rating, which would probably be the highest in the team, I think it is. Olmo was our... We had 2 players on 2020, so Olmo had 21 goals, 23 assists. He got 16-17 in the Prem. That is disgusting. Jeez Louise, mate. That's crazy. Leon Bailey, very inconsistent, but when he had his moments, he was probably our best player, to be honest. When he was in the mood, he was unplayable. 11-7 in the Prem isn't too bad, considering you have players like Marlon Olmo and Rashford in your team, and even Valverde and stuff like that. Speaking of Valverde, he ended up with 13 goals and 15 assists. Just such a beast of a player. Our squad's actually very young. All these first 5 players are 25 or under. Then you got these guys, some more experienced players. But yeah, Valverde, 8-11 in the Prem. He averaged an 8 match rating in the FA Cup. What a beast. We had Ward-Prowse, who we brought in last season, and halfway through I wanted to get rid of him, and then he turned into this incredible all-rounded midfielder. I'm so happy to say that he did that. 9 goals and 15 assists. One of them, or 2 of them actually, coming in the last few games. In the FA Cup final and in the... he got 2 assists in the FA Cup final, sorry. But he also got 1 in the Champions League final for Laporte's goal. Speaking of Laporte, here he is. 3 in the Prem, 1 in the Champions League, and 1 in the FA Cup. Both of them were in the finals of those competitions. So 5 goals, 3 assists for him. 5-6 for Firpo. Very, very good. Up and back, you know, up and down the pitch. So good. By the way, Laporte, but definitely our best signing of the career mode. End of story. Firpo, just a beast. Just such a beast. Rodrigo was good to bring off the bench. So good at left back, by the way. Pavon was one of my favourite signings. He did what he had to do. He played quite a few games, actually, considering he spent most of the time on the bench. Walker was mustard, you know. So good for a 34-year-old. So good. Bamford and Dallas didn't really get much of a look. Neither did Sergio Ramos, to be honest. But, Christian Romero, I'm so glad we picked him up. He was immense for us. Apart from that, kind of all the big name players. As for an overview of Mr. Robert Obflob's time here at Leeds United, we played 166 games, won 102 of them, drew 35, lost 29, that's a pretty good record, scored 348 goals and conceded 192. Our biggest loss was 4-1 to Spurs, which isn't really that bad, but that was back in our first season. And then this season, we beat Burnley 7-0. So, yeah. 107 mil paid for Rashford was obviously our biggest transfer payment. What an incredible game. Freaking career mode we've had. What a team we have built. I'm really going to miss playing with Leeds United on FIFA 22, but hopefully I can get a good amount of content out for FIFA 23. I do want to thank you very, very much for watching this video and this career mode and all the episodes. 22 episodes was the amount of time it took for the series to be completed, which is actually one less than the Tottenham career mode back on FIFA 20, which is quite interesting. So, yeah, I'm just very appreciative of the support. I'd appreciate it if you liked the video and if you subscribed to the channel, gave me feedback, communicated with me, whatever you need to do, whatever you want to do, really, at the end of the day. But thank you very much for watching. Goodbye, Leeds career mode on FIFA 22, and I'll see you in the next video.